Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, cost of equity formula, watch the video till the end. And also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone, and today we have a fantastic topic, cost of equity, something which is used actually, weighted average cost of capital or cost of equity. Those are used for calculating for your valuation purposes. So well, here we begin. We are doing this topic from the box of Pandora called valuation. And in that we have discounted cash flows. Discounted cash flows gives a rise to cost of equity. So what we do have in our session today, first we will try to learn what exactly the formula is all about. There are a few methods for calculating this formula. So we'll try and evaluate through different methods. We'll take an example with the help of evaluating those two methods. Post facto, what we'll try and do, we'll try and understand with the help of the real life example. And in the end, we'll try and learn how does the cost of equity formula calculator works. Well, here we begin with the cost of equity formula. So, cost of equity formula, there are two methods. Method number one for the companies who are dividend paying companies. So KE is known as the cost of equity as a part of disclosing, or you know, if you want to see what cost of equity looks like, then it's KE. Okay. So KE is equal to your dividend per share divided by market price per share. Dividend per share by market price per share is your dividend ratio, right? Plus your return. So your dividend ratio in terms of percentage plus your return is what is your cost of equity. Method number two is expected return, that is basically your cost of equity, is equal to RF. RF means your free rate of return, that is your government bonds rate, something which has no risk, treasury bonds, government securities, plus beta. Beta is what? It is a change of price due to change in the index. It is basically the sensitivity of the stock to the market. What exactly is the sensitivity of the stock? How risky it is? How averse it is? Then, so RF plus beta, it's RM, risk of the market, or EM. It is basically the risk of the market minus the risk of the from the free rate of return. Well, here we begin on, so what is cost of equity formula? So cost of equity, that is key, is what basically the shareholders, they expect for investing their equity into the firm. So the cost of the equity formula can be calculated through method one, as I just explained to you, that is the cost of equity formula for dividend companies. And method number two, cost of equity formula using the CAPM model, that is capital asset pricing model. We'll discuss each of the methods in detail. Let me start with method number one, that is cost of equity KE for dividend companies. Well, so KE is equal to your dividend per share, okay, divided by market price per share plus R. So here, DPS is your dividend per share, MPS is your market price per share, and R is your growth rate of the dividend. I'm so sorry, that was not the return, but it's the growth rate of dividends. So your dividend percentage, you are trying to grow with the help of growth rate. So the dividend growth model basically requires that a company pays dividend, and it is based on the upcoming dividend. Upcoming means the dividend that are going to come in the near futures. So the logic behind this equation is that, you know, company's obligation to pay dividend is the cost of paying its shareholders, and therefore KE is the cost of equity, and this is limited model in the interpretation of the costs. So now let's do this with the help of an example. Let me try and evaluate. Let's try calculate for cost of the equity formula with the first formula, and we assume company is paying a regular dividend. Suppose let's a company is named as XYZ and it is regular paying dividend company, and its stock price is trading closely around at let's say 20. It expects to pay dividend at 3.2 next year, let's say. And following the dividend payment history, what we need to calculate is the cost of the equity. Let's say for year 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We have dividend 3, you increase it to every time, you know, by 5%, 3.05, 3.11, 3.16. Just a way of showing that, you know, this is how the dividend is increasing. So, how does the solution will go about? So, let's first calculate the average growth. What? The average growth rate of the dividend continuing the same formula as per the yield for the yearly growth. So, how do you calculate that? Well, it's quite simple. The growth rate over here is calculated at, this will be not applicable, there won't be any growth rate here. Here, 3.02 divide by B2, 3 minus 1. Simple as that. Just make it a percentage and do control D and you have the answer. What you want to do is probably just increase the decimals. So the growth rate for all these years are this. Okay. So now take a simple average growth rate which will come down to is equal to average of all of this. That comes down to 1.31. So this is the input now. So now the cost of the equity formula is going to be as simple as that now. Very easy. Is equal to the what we call as the dividend per share, that is 3.2, divide by the market price per share 20 and plus 1.31%. And well, that comes down to 17% is what the cost of equity is. Okay. So this is how the whole formula is calculated. Now this is the example of Infosys. You know, if you see here, the dividend history of the company ignoring the interim and special dividend, announcement, effective date, what is the dividend type, the percentage, and some details. So as you can see, the share price of Infosys was 678 on BSE. Average dividend growth was 6.9 and computed from the above table paid in the last dividend 20 per share. Now let's calculate with the help of method number 2. Method number 2 was ER, expected return is equal to your RF plus beta bracket RM minus RF. Okay, this is it. Well, let's begin on this. So the capital asset pricing model CAPM, however, can be used on a number of stocks, even if they are not paying dividends. And with that said, the logic behind the CAPM is rather very complicated, which suggests the cost of equity is based on the stock volatility. Okay. It is based on the stock volatility, which is computed by beta. Remember that. As I told you, beta, what beta is all about. Right. And the level of the risk that is compared to the general market, that is equity market risk premium, which is nothing but your difference between RM minus small rm minus rf. Okay, so in the CAPM equation, the risk-free return is the rate of the return that is paid to the risk-free investments like government bonds, treasuries, and beta is a measure of basically a risk that can be calculated as a regression of the company's market price. So the higher the volatility, remember, higher the volatility it goes, the higher the beta is gonna be. Simple as that. Direct relation. And the relative risk compared to the general stock market. So the market rate of the return, EMR, is the average market rate, which has generally been assumed to be 11-12%. And it's over the past 8 years. So in general, a company with a high beta have a high degree of risk that will pay you more equity. Let me take you an example so that you have an idea of what we are talking about here. XYZ, your RF, let's say 3, 3.4, and 4. Then we have your beta. Beta is 1.11, 0.98, and 1.4. And final is your market return. 7, 7, and 7. We'll take it as same. So solution over here. First, we'll try and calculate the equity risk premium, which is differential between the market rate of return. Okay, so what we are trying to calculate is your RM. I'll just try and align this all in the middle so that it's more in a visible view. Well, so now RM is going to be market rate of return is equal to market rate of return minus the risk-free rate, control R. Okay. Then we have the equity So basically, sorry, this is basically the equity risk premium. It's called ERM. ERM, right? So then we'll calculate the cost of the equity, that is as per the CAPM method. CAPM is RF plus beta, EM minus RF, that is your risk free rate, plus beta, equity risk premium. So continuing the same formula, cost of equity is equal to your risk free rate plus your beta into risk premium. We already found risk premium, right? So this is going to be your cost of equity. I hope you have got an idea how things are been calculated here. Well, finally, let me show you the cost of the equity formula calculator. How does exactly that works? So the dividend per share, let's say over here, I'll take 10. Market price per share, let me take as 20. Growth rate as 10%. 60% comes to your cost of equity. Let's say your dividend was only 1, it comes down to 15, right? Just 10%. So 10%, and I'm growing dividend at 10%. So well, that's how you can make things for your flow. Well, there are some relevance and use of cost of equity. Well, a firm basically uses a cost of equity to assess the relative attractiveness of its opportunity in the form of investments, and including both the external projects and the internal acquisition. So the companies will typically use the combination of debt and equity financing, with equity capital is proving to be more expensive. Second, investors are willing to invest in stock also uses the cost of equity, okay, to find whether the company is earning a rate of return that is greater than that and less than or equal to that rate. Third, the equity analyst and research analyst, the buy or sell side analyst, who are majorly involved in financing modeling and issue research reports, uses this kind of cost equity to arrive at the valuation of the companies. They follow then accordingly advise whether the stock is over or undervalued and then take the investment decision based on that. There are many other methods also used to compute the cost of equity, which are running regression analysis, a multi-factor model, and survey method, and so on and so forth. Okay, so I hope you guys have got a fantastic idea after studying this topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone once again for joining the session.